In this illustration, I will analyze the acceleration of a point on a rolling disk. Here we are given that a disk of radius r is in pure rolling on a horizontal surface at a uniform speed v as shown in figure. And we are required to find the acceleration of points A, B and C at the instant point C is at the bottom and A is at the top. Now, in this situation, here we can write for pure rolling, the value of angular speed will be v by r. And here we can write the velocities of points A, B and C r. Here we can write velocity of A, we can write as v plus r omega, that is equals to 2v. Velocity of B will be root of v square plus r square omega square, that is root 2v. And for point C, we can say its velocity will be 0 because C is at rest. And in case of pure rolling, this is the point where instantaneous axis of rotation exists and it is considered at instantaneous rest. And if we analyze the disk in the reference frame of its center of mass, then we can see accelerations of A, B and C in frame of center of mass of disk as, if we just have a look on this disk, this point is A, this point is B and this point is C. So we can see with respect to center of mass, the disk is only having the angular speed omega, or the point A is moving forward with the speed V, B is moving down with the speed V and C is moving toward left with V and D is going up at V. As we are assuming the disk to be at rest with respect to center of mass. So, all these points are in pure circular motion. So, they are having only normal acceleration acting towards center. This as AA, this as AB and this as AC. So, here we can write with respect to center mass of disk, acceleration of AB and CR. Here we can write acceleration of A will be V square by R in downward direction. Acceleration of B will be V square by R in leftward direction. And acceleration of C will be V square by R in upward direction. And here we can say as center of mass is moving at a uniform speed, this implies it is an inertial reference frame. So, accelerations of A, B and C will be same in ground frame also. This implies here acceleration of A in magnitude is equal to acceleration of B in magnitude is equal to acceleration of C, and this V square by R, that is the result of this problem. The only difference is A is having an acceleration in downward direction, B is in leftward direction and C is in upward direction.